Hey, what's going on, guys? So we're back once again, as you'll notice. But there's a nice little change. First off, we have a better weapon. We got a nicer shield. It's still a crappy bronze shield, but it's nicer than the wooden one we had. And we've also got up about 84 levels. So I've had a little bit of free spare time in between now and the last episode. And I've used it to definitely improve our woodcutting and our fire making, because that was pretty simple. I did it right here next to the castle, just using these trees and the oak behind the store here. Wasn't a big deal. I also used the goblins across the river to kill, and I got a bunch of the experience for attack and defense and strength that way. I really haven't even had to move, so I just stayed in this area. And what's really funny is I realized today there's only about 1,800 people doing the Ironman challenge, the ultimate Ironman challenge on RuneScape, and we've already made it over halfway up the leaderboards just from the small amount of work I've done. I've put maybe 2 hours of work into this account, 2.5. It's really not bad at all. That guy's pissed. But, yeah, we'll come in here, and I'm going to be doing some quests this episode, so we're going to talk to Fred the farmer here. What are you doing on my land? You're not the one who keeps leaving all my gates open and letting out all my sheep, are you? That's actually pretty funny, everyone does that. No. I'm looking for a quest. You're looking for a quest, you say? Actually, I could do with a bit of help. My sheep are getting mighty woolly, and I'd be much obliged if you could shear them. And while you're at it, spin the wool for me, too. Oh, crap. Okay. Yes, that's it. Bring me 20 balls of wool. I'm jeez. Okay. Okay, I can do that. No problem. And I won't worry about the penguins. Let's go. So, for some reason, there's actually two penguins inside his fence. I'm sure I'll try to shear them by accident. I'm gonna take his shears. I don't have enough space for 20 balls of wool. I guess I'll just eat some of this chicken. I can always make some more. I did get my cooking up a little bit. I got it to 9, but that's not great, but I did get it up. After we do one or two quests in this episode, we'll probably jump over, do some grinding on the fishing and stuff like that. At least get it started so that I can do some off-screen. Alrighty, let's get this. I should have enough for exactly 20 balls. Or 20 wool pieces, and then convert it to 20 balls of wool. These things are always obnoxious as crap. So it's gonna take me a while to get these. I will jump cut here so you guys don't have to watch me do this for 20 balls of wool. And I'll be right back. Okay, we've almost come up on the last bit of wool we need, but I wanted to show this off. I'll see if I can get a good camera angle here. These are actually two penguins inside here, and I don't understand. I think there's a quest that semi-explains it, like you have to let them escape from the zoo or something like that. But either way, we got all our wool. That's all we need. We'll run into the castle real quick. I don't think we need to do anything. And if I remember correctly, if you tell the farmer about the penguins, he doesn't believe you. He thinks you're retarded, for lack of a better word, and he wants to call somebody to help you out because he doesn't think you have the mental capabilities to understand there's something attacking his sheep, not some penguins hiding in a sheep costume, which sounds absurd to pretty any rational person. But here we go, let's spin this up real quick. 20 balls of wool coming right up. It's a relatively easy quest. And we can take off. Cool. Let's go on down and return these to him. I think the next quest we're going to do is the Goblin Diplomacy. I'll probably skip everything else until later, because it is going to take us a while to do goblin diplomacy. Instead of trying to grind out some of this stuff, we'll just do that. I did it on another account while I was streaming for charity recently on RuneScape, and I believe you need orange dye and blue dye, if I'm not mistaken, orange and blue. So we're gonna need two guam leaves, which are from Falador, and then we're gonna need some red cherries or red berries, whatever you want to say. We get those. Talk to Fred real quick. We get those from Varrock, and then we're gonna have to get two onions for yellow dye, and I think that's it. I'm back. Cool. I'm not gonna tell him about the penguins because I know he doesn't believe me. There we go. Here's the last of them. Sweet. 60 coins is not worth it, but the 150 crafting experience is. Level 3. Cool. Got two crafting levels from that. Alrighty, let's take off. Start running down. Wait. I think we should probably pass through Varrock first. We're gonna need to get the cherries from Varrock. It's gonna be quite a walk, and I just ran out of run, so I'll probably do a nice shift for you right now. And just like that, we're already approaching Varrock. It's like magic. Alright, I believe. Actually, let's stop running. I think the red berry. Yep, right here. Red berry bush. Which I assume are cherries. Because that's exactly what they look like. Cool. So we'll take that down. I think it might be easier to just teleport. Gotta love all these people just walking past. Alright, cool. So we're back. We can run around. Once again, I don't have much run, but we're gonna have to take the red berries. Trying to think if I'm forgetting anything. I know we need onions, the red berries, and the cyan, so we're gonna have to go to Falador. And that's gonna be quite a walk as well. So I think I'll do another nice fancy little walk for you, the magic jump, and we'll be there shortly. Just like that. Man, I swear. I'm a magician. That 5 minute walk just gone. Alrighty, so we're back here. I believe we can get the guam leaves from the gardener here in Falador. If I'm mistaken, that's gonna suck because I did just walk for 5 minutes to get here. But I mean, oh well, it's all in a day's work, I suppose. So I'm gonna try to prevent from running until we pick up the leaves because we have to go down, grab some onions. And then we have all of the color requirements to go get the dyes. Then we have to take another magic walk up to the Goblin Village, which we should be able to pick up and finish the quest immediately there. So, it's gonna be pretty cool. We got two quests done so far. Whoop, I didn't mean to attack you. But I guess, hell yeah, bring it on, level 4 gardener. I'm gonna kill you. First thing over level 2 that I've killed. Ha ha! Got you! Alrighty, so Weissen the gardener. Sorry about that, my phone went off. I had to quickly mute it. I'm the head gardener around here, and you're looking for woad leaves, or you need help with it? I'm your man. Yes, please. I would like some leaves. How much are you willing to pay? 20 coins, because I'm a generous person. Okay, that's more than fair. Here, have two. You're a generous person. Hey, look, I just said that. Thank you. Okay, I got two leaves. We can use those for our dyes. Now let's see if we can go grab our onions. I'll try to run there. Hopefully we're not gonna run out, because I want to get there in one cut and not do too many jump cuts or magic walks, as you may have me refer to them. I believe there are onions right south of Falador. If not, I'm gonna have to look up a map and figure out where it is. But I'm pretty sure there's farms south of Falador. Uh-oh. Maybe southwest? That's a mining area. We gotta be getting somewhere. I can't be losing my mind. Okay, yeah, that's a farm right there. And there's onions? Yes! Sweet. Okay. So let's grab two onions, and then we can run off to the witch in Draenor Village, which is far east from here. We will get there shortly. Cool, and we're already here. Okay, so I'm pretty sure there's a witch, and I'm pretty sure in that house. Once again, I'm gonna try to save as much of this run because I have one heck of a walk that I'm about to have to do. We're gonna have to go even further north than Falador here in a moment. Thankfully, I can do my magic walk. Let's talk to you. What can I help you with? Can you make some dyes for me? I would like some red dye. Cool, it's only 5 coins. Wait, did you say 3 red berries? Uh-oh. Please don't be 3 red berries. Oh, well, let's see what else dye we can make. I know we have enough for the blue. Okay. Okay, make the blue dye. I may have to go back to Varrok, which would be a problem, but okay. I can deal with it. Yellow dye. I need 2 onions, right? Yep, okay. Make some yellow dye. I thought I only needed 1 berry. I need some red dye. Ah, crap. Okay. Oh, well, I guess I'll do a fancy little walk cut and we will jump over from here to Varrok. I'll be right back. And poof, look at that. We're already back. You're kind of thinking, what the heck? I thought you were going to Varrok. Well, guess what? That magic jump was so powerful, we already got our 2 magic berries and we're back here. God damn it, why is this guy following me? Can you make dyes for me, please? I would like some red dye. Cool, thank you. Now, let's take off, because I don't know why this guy's following, but it's obnoxious. We're gonna try to avoid that. People that tend to follow you like that are just about to ask you for money. Cool. So we have 50 run. We're probably not gonna get all the way up to Goblin Village, but we're gonna get relatively close, and I think I can keep the commentary up until then. What we're basically gonna have to do is run up there. Talk to the bickering goblins because they're trying to do a armor color change. And what's obnoxious is they change to the same color that they already have. But what we're gonna do is combine this red and yellow to make orange dye, like I just did. And we're going to dye 3 sets of armor. Technically, we're going to dye two sets of armor and then leave one the same color, and then they're going to magically love the same color they're already wearing. It's really retarded the way it's set up, but oh well. We'll get it running. Jeez, it's so slow. I'm used to having 20 to 30 agility on my other characters, so this, whenever he stops running, it just ticks up once every 20 seconds. It's pretty excruciating. Thankfully, we're already two-thirds away there. I think we can get all the armor there in crates, if I'm not mistaken. I've already sold like 15 pairs of that armor in order to get my new weapon. So I really, really hope we can get some from the crates and I don't have to worry about it. I guess we'll see. Cool, so we got some run back, we can get up there. So close, yet so far. So I think I'm gonna content myself with just training with these, mainly the combat and our archery, until I do the next recording. It'll probably be another week until I record again. But so that I'm not training all these skills that I would at least want to start on video, I'll make sure that I can train these. I'll pretty much be in this village, and you're seeing exactly what's going to be happening for hours on end. It's not very entertaining. Alright, so here we go. I tell all goblins in the village to wear green armor now, and they not listen to you. I always tell them to wear red armor. They listen to me, not you. They know me bigger, General. Okay, they bicker back and forth quite a bit. Okay, so if you want me to pick an armor color for you, yes, as long as you pick green. No, you have to pick red. What about a different color? Not green or red. That would mean that's me wrong, but at least Warface not right. There you go. You both are wrong. That's a great way to look at that. Pessimistic all the way. Okay, so he wants orange, I believe. I did successfully start that quest, and he wants orange. Yes, orange goblin armor. I believe the best place to get this is upstairs. That's where at least my memory is telling me to get this. Love how my character had to do a triple take there to understand where to go. Uh-oh. Okay, we can search this crate. Cool, found some goblin armor. Okay, well that's one. It's not very helpful. One out of the three that's needed. Okay, there's a crate right there. And it'll let me search it, so I'm sure that has some armor. There we go. Two pieces. One more is all we need. What the heck? This guy has a ladder? Oh, you have to be a member. That's cool. Is there no other crates? You lying scumbags! Need one more crate. One more set of armor. Huh. Really hope I don't have to kill these guys. I'm gonna give it one more shot to look around. Maybe I can check that same crate that I already did. Maybe it'll give me two pieces. Nope. Well, crapper. Okay, I'll be right back because I'm gonna have to find an armor piece. Oh, that's convenient. What do you need your help with? What is this? That is a helmet. Cool, I just got a bunch of gold. That's a cool sign. But yeah, like I was about to say, I got my third piece of armor. I had to do a little bit of coercing. I can get rid of that evidence right now. Ta-da! Okay. So, I'm pretty sure we're gonna need one of these is orange and one is blue. Now, we can always die again. I only got two out of these. Oops, I didn't mean to do that. Cool, we'll at least get a level on screen, because I'm pretty sure... Yep. One more hit, and I'm about to level the strength. Ta-da! Doing a lot of good damage now. Okay, talk to General Bentnose or General Wartface, whichever. Okay. So, after they bitch back and forth about red and green, I have some orange armor here. And let's watch a mini... Ta-da, look. It looks all nice. Oh, oops, that's the brown one. I forgot. Technically, the brown one's the one they're gonna choose anyway, so it does look nice. Super orange. They don't like it. It clashes with the skin color. They need darker color, like blue. Okay, well. What a coinkydink. I have blue armor for you. Okay. Here's some blue armor. Grubfoot! Come put this armor on. Strip down. Be naked for us. It doesn't look half bad, to be honest. Alright. Darker colors. Like brown. Yeah, okay, so brown armor. Even though that's exactly what you had on this whole time. Okay, so... Here's some brown armor. Grubfoot, come here. Take your blue armor off. You look ridiculous. And emerges wearing brown armor. Ta-da! Hey, look! It looks quite nice. Thank you for sorting out our argument. Take this gold bar as a reward. 5 quest points, 200 crafting... Ooh, cool, crafting EXP. And a single gold bar. Gold bar, not worth it. 2 crafting levels, kinda worth it. Cool, we can make gold rings now. Sweet! Alright, so I think I'll call it there for this episode. I guess thanks for watching. Leave a like below if you liked the episode, and we'll continue this series later. Like I said, I'm going to be doing this basically just in this village right here, just killing people. I'll be doing that in my spare time until the next episode, and I may do a live stream to show ranking up on our high scores in the next. Speaking of which, we are rank 894 at the moment, being week in, so I'll probably try to keep track of that and see how well we get, how far we jump up each week, and see how much we do go. Peace out.